Please hit the bell along with the subscribes button as you listen. Mary Catherine James Shell, previously Mary Hosking, usually known as Mary Kay Shell, was born on February 9, 1927 and died on June 14, 2018. She was the first woman to have served as mayor of Bakersfield, California 1981 to 1985, and only the second woman to have served on the Kern County Board of Supervisors 1985 to 1997. At the time of her retirement from public office, Shell was termed by the Bakersfield Californian as the most popular politician in Kern County history. She was the widow of Joseph C. Shell, Sr. 1918 to 2008, a former Republican minority leader of the California State Assembly from Los Angeles, Richard M. Nixon's intra-party opponent for governor in 1962. And a lawmaker who fought to bring water to Southern California in the 1960s. Shell was the younger of two daughters born in Bakersfield to Walter James 1897 to 1972 and the former Mary Ellen Young 1897 to 1990. Shell's paternal grandfather, Harris E. James, arrived in Bakersfield about 1900 to work as a welder for the Southern Pacific Railroad. He opened a welding shop which evolved into H.E. James and Son, an automobile repair business on Chester Street. Mary Kay, also called Mickey by her family and friends, worked in the shop, doing chores traditionally associated with males. She recalls servicing a Buick when news of the D-Day landings in Normandy of June 6, 1944 were announced by radio. She demonstrated a youthful interest in current events, journalism, and politics. She was the editor of the student newspapers at Washington Junior High School and East Bakersfield High School. She was also a song leader and secretary to the student council. Shell said that so many extracurricular activities kept her from being a student. Shell attended Bakersfield College, a public community college, but dropped out a semester shy of receiving her associate's degree. She is a donor to the college and a member of its foundation board. Instead, she worked part-time at the Bakersfield Californian newspaper, where at the age of 17 she had been the cub reporter on the farm beat. She soon learned that city officials were making most decisions over lunch at the Hotel Eltergen, now the site of the Bank of America building in Bakersfield, and then routinely approving what had been decided at council meetings. This was long before the era of open meetings laws, known in California as the Ralph M. Brown Act. Shell had taken flying lessons while she worked as a flight dispatcher at La Cresta Airfield near the Panorama Bluffs of Bakersfield. In 1945, at the age of 18, she married Army Air Corps Lieutenant Don Sticker, but the couple divorced in 1947. She married Richard Dick Hosking in 1948, by whom she had three children. Jeffrey Richard Hosking was born in 1951, Timothy William Hosking 1952 to 1979, and Meredith Catherine Hosking 1959 to 1981. The couple lived briefly in the San Jose area, where Hosking attended Santa Clara Law School, and she worked at the San Jose Airport. They soon returned to Bakersfield, and she became a secretary to a cotton cooperative. Dick served on the Bakersfield City Council from 1965 to 1969. Mary and Dick separated in 1967 and divorced 2 years later. In 1970 she wed Joe Shell, a distinguished flight instructor during World War II who, like her, held a pilot's license. When Joe ran for California governor in 1962, she helped in his campaign in Kern County. 4. Mary was later a reporter, photographer and then, the editor, of the News Bulletin, a semi-weekly newspaper serving a metropolitan Bakersfield. From 1970 to 1980, Mary K. Shell was a correspondent based in the state capital of Sacramento for the Californian and the syndicated Capital News Service. She covered the legislature and other state agencies, that was before we even had fax machines, she recalls. She wrote her weekly column on a typewriter and shipped it to Bakersfield on a Greyhound bus. Shell's old job was discontinued by the newspaper in 2007 because of financial reasons. Shell won honors, the 1972 Excellence in Reporting Award from the California Trial Lawyers Association and the 1975 California Taxpayers Reporting Award for her revelations about excessive early retirement benefits for legislators, a phenomenon unknown to many California voters. Joe was a lobbyist for oil companies while the couple lived in Sacramento. During that period, they generally made two trips monthly to Bakersfield, where they would move permanently in 1980. In 1978, the Shells opened an oil business together and drilled 4 heavy oil wells in at the Deer Creek field in Tulare County, located adjacent to Kern County. Because the name Shell could not be used, they called the endeavor Concho Petroleum. They maintained the low-output wells until 1993. She was unopposed in 1988. In 1992, after redistricting, her district became even more prominently Hispanic and Democratic in orientation with the inclusion of the Arvin and Lamont neighborhoods. Shell still polled 61.2% of the vote against Ray Gonzalez and another candidate. She did not seek a fourth term in 1996, and the position went to Pete Parra. While in office, she personally hosted many social gatherings and joined constituents in cleaning up litter-strewn lots. Out of office, she did consulting work for individuals and companies having problems with the bureaucracy of government. When asked her most memorable accomplishment in office, Shell replied that it was the diversion of grant funds to establish a lighted soccer field in an underserved area of the city and the coordination undertaken for an American Youth Soccer Organization program. She was a member of the St. Francis of Assisi Catholic Church in Bakersfield. She died at 91 years old.